As an advanced medical practitioner, pharmacist, practicing in family medicine, I've seen firsthand just how little mistakes when you take your blood pressure readings can have a significant impact on your blood pressure readings, giving incorrect readings. So in this video, we're going to conduct an experiment. We're going to see just how much making these simple mistakes can affect your blood pressure. So what tests are we going to do? We're first going to see what happens to your blood pressure when your arm isn't supported and the cuff isn't at heart level. We're secondly going to see what happens to your blood pressure if your cuff is too small or too big. Third, we're going to see what happens to your blood pressure when you take your reading over a jumper or a sweater, basically when you don't have your bare arm. And fourth, one that a lot of you might not know, we're going to see how temperature affects your blood pressure. I'm really excited for this one. I hope you are too. Let's begin. So first things first, what we're going to do is we're going to get our baseline blood pressure and we're going to compare this to all the other blood pressure readings that we do. I'm going to take the baseline properly, so we're going to do everything correct. So first of all, I'm following the 30-minute rule. This means that 30 minutes before I take the blood pressure reading, I'm not eating, I'm not smoking, I'm having no caffeine, and also I'm not exercising beforehand. Secondly, you can see that I'm sat comfortably with my feet flat on the floor, my back supported, my arms are supported, and my arms are resting at heart level, and I have gone to the bathroom, I've had a break, I don't have a full bladder. Thirdly, you can see the position of the cuff is correct, so it's about two fingers above my elbow. It's snug, but not too tight, just enough so I can fit two fingers underneath. And I'm also using the correct cuff size because it's critical, because the wrong cuff size can give you incorrect readings. Fourth of all, you can see with all our A&D medical cuffs, they come with a marker and this is aligned correctly. So it's aligned with my middle finger for perfect placement. And fifth of all, when I'm ready, I'm gonna click the start button. I've made sure my arms are supported. I'm not moving, I'm not chewing, I'm not talking, and I'm not blocking the tube. This is the gold standard for getting accurate blood pressure readings. Now, in this video experiment, I will be using our A&D Medical Precision Check Pro device. This will be the device that I use through the entire video for all the readings that I take. One thing that I love about this device is it's got our trademarked tri-check technology. So what that basically means is when you take a blood pressure reading at home, you usually take three readings and you'll have 1 minute intervals. The tri-check technology does that automatically. So it'll take a reading, it'll then wait 60 seconds and then take another one and then it'll repeat again. So we'll have three readings and it will average it out and it'll have it on screen, which I will show you through the video. And by the way, this does comply with the American Medical Association's recommended method for taking blood pressure. So now that I've taken my blood pressure and I've used the tri-check technology, you can see my reading there. So it's 123/78 mmHg. That's my blood pressure. That's going to be the baseline from now on. So 123/78, that is the blood pressure reading we're going to be comparing everything against. And you can see my pulse is 79. So it's a pretty good blood pressure. I'm happy with that. So now let's begin with the experiment. So experiment number one, we're gonna take the blood pressure reading with my arm not supported and also the cuff not at heart level. So you'll notice it in the video where I'm actually taking the blood pressure, these are incorrect. Again, for all the experiments, I'm gonna be using our tri-check technology. So it's gonna be taking the three readings with 60 second breaks in between each one and it's gonna average it. So I'm gonna show you that on every single one. So that's just a note to remember in this experiment, that's how we're gonna take the readings. This is quite common, by the way, this mistake that I see a lot of patients do make where their arms aren't fully supported and sometimes not at heart level. So really do think about if you are making that mistake as well. Okay guys, results are in. I have really enjoyed doing this experiment. So remember, baseline when we did the blood pressure correct, my blood pressure was 123/78 mmHg. So arm unsupported and cuff not at heart level. This was my reading that I got, 136/68. 136/68. So you can see we've had an increase in blood pressure in the systolic massively. So it's really important that we're in the right position, that we're feeling supported when we're doing the blood pressure. So if we don't, you see, it's gonna bring up our blood pressure reading. Moving on to experiment number two, I've had to take my white coat off in order to do this. And that is using a cuff that is too small for my arm. So to do this, I've got my trusty measuring tape here and my midpoint, I've already calculated it. If you ever need to learn how to actually measure your cuff size properly, we have a video on it, so definitely do check it out. But I know my midpoint is here because I've already calculated it. My circumference, my arm circumference is about 12 inch. Okay, so if you look at the table now on screen, you're going to see that basically my arm at 12 inch circumference is correct for our wide range cuff that comes with most of our devices at A&D Medical as standard. And you can see, looking at the table, the small adult cuff is too small for me. So that's the one I'm using for the small experiment. And you can see the large adult cuff one is too big for me. So that's what I'm gonna use for a cuff that's too big for the experiment. So as you can see in this video, whilst I'm taking my blood pressure, I'm doing everything correct. The only difference is the cuff is different and it's the small adult cuff that's too small for me. Moving on to experiment number two. So remember, the cuff size was too small. Honestly, it was actually quite painful having my blood pressure done with such a small cuff. And actually on the monitor, the UA910BLE, the A&D Medical one, it actually did come up that there's a cuff size detection warning. So that was really good. So you can see my baseline was 123 over 78, remember? The blood pressure went up to 139 over 70. 139 over 70 when you have a small cuff. So you can see you need to have the right cuff size. Again, refer to the part of the video where we go through the table. Measure your arm. We have a video on cuff size selection and making sure you have the right cuff size. So watch that video too, because as you can see, it's massively increased the blood pressure, giving us a false higher reading. And straight on to experiment number three. Now we're going to use a cuff that's too big for me. Remember, again, the table is going to show up now on screen. My arm circumference when we calculated was 12 inch. So the large adult cuff is too big for me. So again, in this experiment, the only difference right now is everything's being done correct, but the cuff is too big for me. So let's see what results we get. I'm just gonna begin this bit of a wow, because the blood pressure cuff that's too big, remember, it's gonna give us a lower reading. That's what I said earlier. So remember my baseline, when we did it right, 123 over 78 millimeters of mercury. The large cuff size gave us a blood pressure of 116 over 83. 116 over 83. So as you can see, it's underestimated my blood pressure because the cuff was too big for my arm. I've said it again, I'm going to say it again. Make sure you are checking your cuff size. You don't want to be getting incorrect blood pressure readings. Watch our video on cuff size, how to wear it properly, how to measure your arm properly. We go through everything in a lot of detail on the A&D Medical channel, so definitely do check it out and stay subscribed to us just to get more and more information as we bring it out, because we bring out new videos every 2 weeks and we have a live show and we have shorts as well. So we've got all the videos coming for you. Moving straight on to experiment number four. This is one that I see very commonly. Patients taking their blood pressure over their sweater, over their jumper, over a shirt, sometimes because it's just too tight to roll up. But again, this is going to affect our blood pressure readings. Let's see exactly what we get. So for this experiment, you can see I'm doing it over my white coat. So let's see exactly how this affects our blood pressure reading. So the results are in. Remember, again, baseline was 123 over 78 when we did it correct. When I took my blood pressure over this sleeve, actually, it's gone up to 129 over 69. So 129 over 69. I'm surprised it wasn't higher than that, but this is quite a thin material. But again, another thing to bear in mind is if you're rolling your sleeves and it's putting a lot of pressure on your bicep, or if you've got thicker material, it's probably going to be even a higher reading, to be all honest. So make sure you're doing it right. Make sure your arm is bare, and make sure to watch our video on how to take your blood pressure properly, where we go through everything step by step in a lot of detail. Moving straight on to experiment number five, we're going to talk about temperature now. This is one that not many medical providers actually know about, so I don't think a lot of patients know about it either. But basically, it's about maintaining a constant temperature in your home. If you are taking your blood pressure in a cold environment, basically what's going to happen is our blood vessels are going to constrict and our blood pressure is going to be higher. All right, so to do this experiment, you can see I'm outside, and I've been basically outside for about 10-15 minutes to try and really get myself cold, to get some real constriction going on. I've just got an image here. I'm in Leeds. The temperature is 12 degrees Celsius. If you're wondering right now what that is in Fahrenheit, give me a second, I'll calculate it. Okay, so in Fahrenheit, it's 53 degrees Fahrenheit. Okay, so it's quite cold outside. And then what I've done then is I've come straight inside. I haven't given myself any time to adjust to the room temperature. My house temperature is usually about 20 degrees Celsius. That's about 68 Fahrenheit. So I haven't given it any real time to sort of adjust. And I've done the blood pressure there. So let's see what we get. So the results are in. This one was really interesting for me. So remember, baseline, normal blood pressure was 123 over 78. And I was outside for about 10, 15 minutes. It was very cold. It was a clear day, so you could see the sun, but it was very cold outside. So I did get quite cold. Eventually I came in and I did rest for about 5 minutes before taking the blood pressure. My blood pressure was at 139 over 70. 139 over 70. So you can see your temperature, if you come from a cold environment into a warmer environment and you haven't given yourself time to adjust, it can make a difference. And also if your room is a lot colder that you're taking the blood pressure, again, that could have an effect as well. Thankfully, our A&D Medical Precision Check Pro device, the blood pressure monitor, actually takes the room temperature as well. So it has the thermometer in there. It records the actual temperature of the room as well. So the beauty of that is that you can review the temperatures of the room as well. And if you've got this abnormally raised blood pressure reading, it could be potentially due to the temperature. So you can see some correlations there as well. I love that feature on this device, and I really can't recommend it enough. So next up, I want to give everyone watching a pro tip about blood pressure monitors and making sure that your blood pressure monitor is validated for accuracy and on the validated device list that we call VDL for short by the American Medical Association, Hypertension Canada, or the British and Irish Society of Hypertension. Because believe me, a lot of the blood pressure monitors you can buy online on Amazon, for example, are not on the VDL list, so they're not accurate. And I've personally been using A&D Medical blood pressure monitors in my very own practice for years because, one, believe me, they are an absolute workhorse when it comes to blood pressure monitors. And secondly, they are on the VDL device list, so they're validated for accuracy through formal studies, so you know you can trust them. By the way, in case you don't know, here at A&D Medical, we are the inventors of the digital home blood pressure monitor back in 1977, all right? So here at A&D Medical, they definitely know how to get accurate readings. Thank you so much for watching this video. I really hope you found this information helpful. I also hope that some of it was a bit of an eye-opener for you, just how much these little mistakes can affect your blood pressure readings. There is also a part one of this video where we do different experiments as well, different errors and mistakes that people make. So definitely watch that video too if you found this one insightful. We have loads more videos on the channel all about cardiovascular health. So, you know, looking at tips that lower blood pressure naturally, looking at how to use your blood pressure monitor properly, looking at cuff sizes. We go through everything on the channel and it's some really useful information. So definitely do check it out. Now, to learn more about A&D Medical and our fantastic product range, I will leave a link in the description below. Please do check it out and learn more about us. And here at A&D Medical, we are committed to helping you stay healthy with reliable products. In fact, all our blood pressure monitors come with a 5-year warranty if you are in the US, Canada, or UK. As we always say at the end of every single video, thank you for watching. A&D Medical, discover precision.